too clear. So maybe I...
Josh, get over. There it is. Yeah! All right! Defense!
They're coming back there, 12 points. That's Josh, huh? That's Josh, Uncle Oza. Is that 40? All right.
Okay, he missed it.
Zappadilly, yeah, then zap it. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Zap it.
Yeah.
You can take a bath. That was what
Lisa wanted. Oh, look, Lisa.
It's a splashing kid.
Look what Susan got.
You like
Isn't
it,
that what you wrote on your list for Santa?
Remember? Well, it was Little Miss Makeup, but now
I'll take it. Yeah, but you know what? You asked me just this afternoon how to spell cabbage.
That's good.
Yeah. Opening my next one. And this one was from you.
Spray it with ink.
And this is from.
And it attacks you on your shirt, but then it goes away by itself.
Greg, Josh, and Joey.
It's just, you know what I mean? It goes away after a while. So it's neat. You know, you spray
it out of your
head. I even bought one for myself. I will not be responsible. You do it. Read the directions. I don't know, Josh. Don't mess it up. Song, Sue. Where are you?
I
want to hear a song.
I want to find the rest of my present.
Let me see your organ.
Oh, there it is.
Pass me your piano. I want to try.
What? Nice.
I poured a little bit too much, but you're supposed to put water in it.
Yeah, but not as much as I have.
Hey, don't catch your stuff.
Shores of Silver Lake.
Yeah.
The long winter.
Thanks.
It's a
sister. Like it?
Yeah. Josh, hold up my
I have two of the same book.
Why? Yes. Too much stew.
Well, I'm going to open up a gift here. It looks like it might be three golf balls.
Open this.
Another one. Oh, these are too heavy for me.
That better be, what is it?
What is it?
A goofy golf ball.
$3.99. Geez, you guys really splurged on this one. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Up close and personal. $3.99. This is our gift from the whole Doucet family. 3 goofy golf balls. How goofy can they be, for God's sakes?
Roll them on the ground.
Oh, well, you know what I'll do? I won't even say anything. I'll bring this there and give them each a golf ball.
Well, it was just for you, and then I thought, well, there's 3 balls.
Merry Christmas.
All right.
Here. Don't spray me anymore, George.
Don't spray it.
Go ahead, open it.
Yes,
no? You. Go ahead.
Maybe.
Yeah?
Mine?
You're from the desert.
Oh, yeah?
Well, that's from
the... Oh!
Damn!
Oh, yeah. Warren's on his way over. We'll let him get on.
Jesus, nice.
Come here. Let me see you, Joey.
Very nice, very nice. That's pretty neat, huh, Josh?
Are you sure?
Thank you.
There you
have that. I know what this is.
This is from Martin
Sue. I know what this is.
Hey, Becky, can you see me there? Hey,
open it. Open it.
Oh, yeah. Please don't stand in front of the camera like that, okay? Yes.
I see what it is, Daddy.
one's got the guards. Maybe the glass will last a little longer.
I like this. Is that from us, Beck?
No, that's too big. Ours isn't that big.
That's my mother. From my father.
We opened it the wrong way.
Lisa, toss over it, please.
See, Josh, there's no glass still with us, Josh.
He's careful.
Cautious, Josh.
Hey, where's my watch?
I'm trying to get it off for you, okay?
Well, I'd like to have it on my wrist sometime before next year. To make it.
Peanuts are all over the place. Oh, this is a good idea.
Where's my watch?
I'm trying to get it, Daddy. Would you wait?
Show me. I know how.
I already got it.
No, wait, the bottom's open too there.
Well, take the bottom there.
Is your watch
there? Is
it next to your yet?
Let me check. I'll see. It's all big over there.
Show me.
And it doesn't do anything fancy, so you don't have to worry about...
Yeah, it just tells time.
Yeah.
Mommy,
it's all right with me.
Does this say Greg? It's in your handwriting. You gotta,
Hey, who's it for?
Do you already have those? No?
I got some of the little ones.
Oh, see that, Daryl? We finally got him something he doesn't have.
I knew that. I checked his toolbox. To see what he's got the regular ones, but he doesn't have the needle though.
Joey.
Show me the
watch. Thank you. Yeah.
Well, you're special too, Greg.
Oh, you cinch, nigga.
Daddy.
Oh, I saw that at the airport. I know what that is. I saw it at the airport. I almost bought it at the airport, to be honest with you. You know that, Beck, Sydney?
No, I gave you the...
Come on in!
Okay, no, this is the paper that explains it's done by a native...
I know, I was reading it.
Okay,
at the airport.
It's upside down, is it?
Hold it. Hold it the right way there, so...
I wanted to put it on a backing, but it would just be too cumbersome.
Oh, it would have been hard to bring it in.
Yeah. Okay. Teamwork. Yay!
Hey!
Look at this. Lisa, they even have a pizza dragon. See, passing the party?
Puppy. No, but it's an adoption for them.
Oh, this is their opening each other's dress. Yeah. Oh, my God.
We waited for you guys.
This is the DCR.
Dad's got it.
Oh, okay.
He's a pro. You go first.
Me first.
Why didn't you go at the same time?
Oh, we got music going.
Oh, this even tells where to put their face.
It's all right, huh?
Oh, my God.
Check it out. It's a passport.
Show the camera.
Oh,
Back of the Bolduc house here. There's Becky. Oh! There's Greg. Greg is the driver here. And here's, Mr. B. Mr. B's inside where it's nice and warm.
Yeah.
There's our snowman that we made the other day. Come on, Cindy, come over here and talk on the camera here. You're shy. Just describe what's going on here. Who's with Becky in back there?
Todd Ouellette.
Todd Ouellette and Becky, and Greg is driving with nothing on his head. He's going to catch a cold. Oh! There goes Becky. Becky's record isn't too hot there.
Shelly brought a snow tube. I don't know how that would work.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, those masks, you do need it. Yeah. Oh, right around the snowman.
It's too bad there's no more snow on the hills.
Oh, is there just enough? There's enough. I just rode down from your house with the four-wheeler. I beat you.
I'm gonna go get Troy.
Okay. Troy? Oh, there's Susan and Pepe. Yes, Susan, what do you want to say? Huh, Sue?
Sue, say I want to go ride too.
I can't believe this.
Who?
Greg.
Now we have Lisa and Shelly and who?
Joey.
And Joey Doucette.
It's funny, you try to steer that thing and you can't.
So what's that now?
You try to steer the sled, you know? You know, I kept trying to go off to the side, like when you water ski.
Yeah. Okay, that was expert commentary by your hostess here, Rebecca Bolduc. And here they come by the snowman. Almost knocking it over. There they go.
There's Daryl.
Greg. here comes Pepe. And Josh in the back.
Well, be careful not to run over anybody.
No worries, Ed.
If I don't worry, who will?
Hey, Troy, did you see him a while ago? His sled flipped over, he hung on, he was upside down.
Oh, yeah, there's no problem there. There's Dad with Josh in the back. Jeez. And there's Greg. Greg's going to pass him. No, oh, he lost the customer there. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
check on how Greg's doing there. Cindy, quit shaking the floor. Oh, here comes Josh again. Oh, I think Greg's stuck or something. Floor it! Floor it, man! Let's go!
Hold on!
Oh, he's going around in circles. What the heck's he doing? Okay, here comes Greg with a couple of sorry guys in the back. Oh, there's Pepe B in the back with Joey and Greg as the driver.
Big Joe, little Joe.
Watch the crowd.
Watch the what? Whoa! Oh!
He lost a customer. He's coming back around to pick him up. I'm back. I'm back. Those two little boys are cute, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez, I'm right.
He's
not gonna last. He's already off. Yeah. Who, Becky?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Where is she?
That's her.
Where?
Back in Skidoo.
Oh, is that her?
I think it is.
It is.
Yeah.
But oh, boy, you feel your ass.
It's okay, it's okay.
There's Bev and Warren. And last but not least, we can't forget the wood burning stove.
The committee is getting the lunch ready over here.
Make sure all the...
Oh, is this thing going?
Turn around and look at the camera.
Oh, yes, we caught it on film. You tumbled off the sled.
Oh, go ahead, yeah, get on the tube, man. Get that tube there. I don't have no boots. I don't want to get my shoes dirty. I mean, full of snow. Put the tape on here, you. Right on the table.
What? No way!
Here we are here over at the Van Buren Long Lake Cove. George and I decided to come to church. So we stopped in here over at the church. We're going to probably go do confession, seeing how we want to go out here for New Year's Eve. It's right on top of the lake here. These here are some fishing huts, ice fishing setups here. Right here in front of the St. Rose Chapel here at Long Lake in Van Buren, Maine. If you can see the beautiful speck setting here, nice little mountain. There's George. What do you think, George? What do people do up here anyway? Uh-huh. You want to say hi to anybody back in Fort Lauderdale?
Yeah. How you doing, Jake? Cold over here, I'll tell you.
So what's new over here in Van Buren, George?
I don't know, Darren. I haven't been here in almost a year.
And when are you going to be coming down to Florida?
I don't know. I'd like to make it this year for sure.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. You going to come gambling with us over in the Bahamas? Uh-huh.
I always wanted to gamble big.
Uh-huh. Well, let us scream out and we'll see. We'll see if we can get him on tape. Hey! Don't look that way, George, unless
there's smoke down there, Dale. Keep
recording. Oh, way across the lake?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Can't get that far, huh?
Oh, I can get it. It's awful small. I'll tell you what.
There's Daryl.
Recording now, George?
Yeah, he's heading toward the beach.
Okay, well, we're going to go check out public beach, see if there's any people down.
There's a few signs there. I don't know what they are. Probably not there. It's too bad, I'm hungry too.
I could use a couple of hot dogs myself.
Yeah, three or four.
Here over here, we might have a fishing house here.
Anybody in there, Daryl? Anybody in there, Daryl? Wonder why. I don't think anybody's gonna sleep in there tonight.
Oh yeah, you're right, George. Look, they got some smoke coming out of that one over there.
Oh yeah.
Snowmobiles over there.
Yeah. They're cold.
That would be quite a walk to get out there, I think.
Yeah, you'd probably freeze to death before you got 50 feet. Wind chill factor is high right now.
Yeah, I'd say it's
with everybody
about,
else.
20 below zero with the wind factor to chill factor right now, George?
At least.
Uh-huh. Yeah, well, I'd say it's probably about 100 degrees warmer in Fort Lauderdale.
Is that a couple of snowmobiles down there, Darryl?
It sure is, yep.
So there is somebody over there.
Definitely. You zero in on that?
Yeah. Uh-huh. About as much as I can zero in right there.
Uh-huh. You think the truck would get us out there?
You're probably right. The truck would go down there, wouldn't it?
Well, the snow is only an inch or two deep.
Oh, yeah, that's hard.
Well, let's get in the truck and see if we can't get the
vehicle. Okay, Darryl.
Huh?
Okay.
Let's head on back.
Sounds like a good idea to me. Seeing how I ain't got any gloves on, and I can't feel my fingers now, so...
Bump saw
yard. I gotta take off the glasses. Just push it in.
Push the red button. Well, down here on the lake road, we might run into a moose. You seen any moose lately, George?
I haven't seen any.
You haven't seen any moose, huh? Well, maybe we're due to see one then. Should we take this road down here?
Yeah, this is my brook, isn't it?
Yeah. Maybe we'll see something down there. There's a beautiful sight there. Check that sign right there. Leash law is enforced. So that means that some of you people from Fort Lauderdale may not be wanted around here.
Especially pit bulls. Well, they must have just plowed this morning, huh, Darryl?
Yeah. Well, no, probably yesterday. It didn't rain last night. It had snow last night. Look at the snow on the trees there, how beautiful that is. With the sun in the backdrop there. Hey, that's a pretty picture right there.
Yeah, gotta flash that.
Brook frozen solid.
Yeah. Almost get him until it's there. Let you go a little faster there.
Well, George, you know, after you've seen some couple thousand trees, they all start to look the same.
Yeah. People in Florida are gonna like to see this, huh?
Yeah, I know, but you got enough of that, them trees. Kill the record.
Trees, I'm getting the road right now. Here we got a couple snowmobiles down there. And a couple kids. I think they're gonna take a ride.
Either that or they brought their girlfriend over to the ice house.
Yeah, I'm planning on coming back. Imagine.
The sun is on the lake. It's beautiful, man.
Yeah, there's a camp here. I don't know who it belongs to.
Hey, George. It works better.
Can't take the lens off there, Mr. Self.
Ask him what the hell he's doing up here.
Still working at the bath?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good.
Good.
Got a couple of big contracts there. A
lot of contracts, Russ. Be good for another 15 years, I think.
Yeah, that's good.
Till he gets his retirement.
How long have you been out?
Up where?
Here.
Since Tuesday.
All right.
How about you?
Monday.
Monday?
Yeah.
You going back?
Tuesday morning.
Yeah?
So where's the big New Year's Eve party?
I don't know, I guess the Legion.
You gonna go?
I guess so.
I guess I'll go too. Huh, George, you gonna go?
No problem.
Should be a good time. Everybody will be there, you know, you'll get to see everybody.
I talked to Steve LaPierre yesterday. He said that I guess that's where I'm going
to go. Yeah, well, it's the only place to go. You don't have any choice. Either there or stay home, man.
Watch the balloon come down to New York.
Yeah, on the TV. So I guess we'll see each other over at the Legion Hall there on New Year's Eve.
Yeah, I played Josh basketball yesterday.
Yeah, he told me. You give him some pointers?
As many as I could.
He's shy, you know? Do you notice that?
He's shy, but he needs to lift weights.
He does? Yeah, that you got a point there. That wouldn't hurt. But I mean, you know, he's and he doesn't, it's as if he doesn't want criticism or anything, you know what I mean?
He doesn't
open up, I guess I should say.
Just a goal.
Yeah. But I think he'd be good. Well, we'll have to buy him some weights. Well, we'll let you guys go here, I guess.
I'll see you in the ditch somewhere, so I'll wave by.
Okay.
Here we all are on the lake road here. Give you an idea of the layout of this area here. Here's some snowmobiles coming down a hill here. There they go, along the tracks. Beautiful place to ride snowmobile here, where they used to have railroad tracks. Behind me goes uphill here. George is a little bit too cold to come outside of the truck there. I think he's a smart one.
What's up, John?
Good.
Say hi to the boys in Florida.
Hey. How's it going there, Jason and Chuck doing?
How's Big George? You feel all right after your big steak?
Yeah, I feel pretty good now. How about you, Darren?
Well, not too bad, yeah.
Good.
Just had a little bite to eat over in St. Leonard at the Japanese joint.
Yeah, that wasn't bad, was it?
Well, it wasn't too bad.
Actually, it was Chinese.
I just had a salad.
Do you have blue cheese in your dressing?
No, a chicken salad. George had a big steak, must have been all about this big, and a black forest cake.
Yeah, it was kind of small, wasn't it?
I grabbed the camera and said, look, we can show you.
3 pounds if you gain.
16 ounce.
He thought he was at Burger King, he ordered a Whopper, and they gave him a steak.
You're going to be cold.
Wesley, you still in here?
Coffee,
Bob?
Johnny,
yeah.
to the dump.
Greg D, il a pris des clôtures.
La clôture, c'est bien meilleur, c'est moins meilleur. À l'autre bout du moulin. C'est sur le bout du côté. À l'autre bout du moulin. Quand t'as dit, toi, un clôture. Je te vois,
je peux y aller
avec mon loader.
Amen.
guy from Caribou, McBride. He's working for Red Bull.
Right there. Come here. Come here. Come here. Look. Look over here. There. See? See your camera just like Dad's. Look in it and say hi, Amy. Back up. Back up. You're too close. Come over here. Come over here.
Come over here.
Come over here and wave hi to Amy. Right?
Say it loud.
Like what?
Say hi, Amy.
L'avion.
Que c'est?
good boy.
Finally, I said, listen, I'll continue the story tomorrow, okay? Oh, that's okay. Yeah. Sign off for now.
Here are the two girls inside the limousine.
Hi, Daddy. Hi, Daddy. Come on. Come on. Get in. Take us for a ride. Hurry.
Yeah. Take a left. It'll be less traffic.
Here we are in the limo here. Darren's the driver. The TV's on. There we go. Susan, mix me a drink, huh?
Okay, I will. Okay. With what? With what?
Oh, let me have a rum and coke.
Okay, here is Lord Canavane.
Susan, what do you think about the limo?
It's cool.
I really like it.
Amen, Daddy. Watch the amen.
Is this an amen? Amen is only on Saturday. This is,
this is the Jeffersons.
What do you think, Dale?
Well, Mark, here we are, Fort Lauderdale Airport.
Ma'am, would you like to comment on the camera here? Would you like to say a few words? Smile, you know. Well, he's just filming us right now. You know, we're in the process of filming. Yeah, it is.
Here's my camera.
Came in from New York.
She blends right into this crew.
Oh, here we go. She wants to join in. She wants to be filmed. She wants to talk to German.
She's from Quebec, Dad.
This guy is
rotten.
Getting cuts. They have.
I've been in Texas.
Oh, my God.
I've been
in Canada.
Oh, yeah?
I'm in Quebec.
Quebec.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, they are rendezvousing around the limousine, as you can see. Darren, the chauffeur, has yet to take control of the situation. He misguided us several times en route to the airport, and we made it. We were here on time. Glenn Cyr in the background here. Now you got Glenn Cyr, Clayton Ouellette, Mark Bolduc, Darren LaJoy, the chauffeur, all from Van Buren, Maine. We found a young lady here, as you can see,
up close and personal.
From Quebec, waiting for limousine service.
Are the bags in the trunk? Right?
Yes,
we ready?
The bags are in the
trunk. Let's know if the luggage is in the trunk.
Oh, this
ma'am,
lady wants to take a picture
me,
of Jay Hudson.
Yeah,
listen.
Ma'am?
Listen, y'all. Let's get over here by the car. This lady's going to take a picture.
Here we go.
Here.
We are on. We are being filmed right now. The lady from Quebec is going to take our picture.
Away,
there she is right there.
Hello.
I'll tell you, don't get her on the back. Later, messed up. Picture, it's one of them. Rockford Files, what's her name?
Oh, that's
not.
Help her out.
Hey!
Oh, she made it. Camera came out. Everybody's excited. Clayton Ouellette, right here.
Okay, let's go.
Right here.
Here, Mark.
Clayton Ouellette.
Thank you.
Let's roll.
There's
he is. There's,
you. I don't know. I'm not an experienced cameraman. I'm having a hard time. Here's JR, the lady from Quebec. Get his tie in the camera, but I can't get his face. I don't know. Here we go. There he is. I'm sorry. I'm, what can I say? I'm just a lousy cameraman.
Alright, let's load it up.
Oh, we're getting ready to leave the limousine. I can't quite get it on here.
Gentlemen, we are here in the limousine.
Get off my feet.
Would you?
But I'm going to call Yanko.
Okay, here we are inside the limousine, and we got Clayton right here. We can't see shit, so we're going to turn off, and we'll catch you on the flip side. See ya.
That's it. It's running.
Here we are. I don't think there's enough light.
It's running now.
All right. Good. Yeah, it's a little better. Here's Mark drinking his drink of rum and coke.
This one's small, huh?
Hey, that's pretty good.
We're approaching Solid Gull. We're trying to focus in on the establishment. Here we go. We're recording license plate number Zoom. Oh, here we are. Famous.
I mean, didn't see anyone.
Famous. Solid.
Gotta put that camera in the trunk or something.
Yeah. We got, ladies and gentlemen, this is a continuation of Solid Gold.
Did you take that into Solid Gold with you, Jay, or what?
No, I didn't. No.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's Darren.
Mark Bolduc. There's Darren.
Say cheese. Maple syrup, Bolduc.
Not surprising like that, yeah, Mark.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get you off,
yeah. Yeah, we'll be the last guy on that dog in a bit. Clayton Ouellette.
See that gun? That's gonna do me a lot of good.
I'm gonna set him up on a new fridge.
Joseph
Bolduc.
That fridge
is kinda old.
It's a dark gun.
I don't know what it is.
Put it in the frost free at least.
Well, yeah, we're over here. We just come.
So let's hit the road, man.
We have
going, Mark.
And now we're at Conrad's here.
We're waiting to hit another plane.
Let's hit the road now!
Fuck it.
Lightning. Here.
Let's go. Let's go.
Here, Lightning.
What would you like?
For photographers and people who write newspapers and even lawyers. I'm a lawyer, and my boss, when I go to work, he says that I look absolutely fantastic. I'm a photographer,
3.
Hi, I've been shopping at Susan and Lisa's absolutely fab warehouse. And I mean, this place is like so great. I've got this mask, these gloves, and this gown, and this dress there. And it's great because I'm a doctor and I operate all day, like I deliver babies. And so, I mean, it's like so comfortable that it's unbelievable. You wouldn't believe how comfortable this thing is. Please, go shopping there. You're gonna love it. People are complaining their feet hurt, their back hurt, their heads hurt. Well, I don't complain a bit because I wear these great dresses that I get at Susan and Lisa's absolutely fab warehouse. Hi, I'm Susan Bolduc, one of the two models here at Susan and Lisa's absolutely fab warehouse fashion show. We get all our clothes from there, and they're all very comfortable. I mean it. We've been to various places and worn these clothes, and we have been absolutely comfortable in them. I mean, no matter what you do, where you go, you're always going to be comfortable. Now, this was just our work section. We have two other categories. The next one is casual, and then the last one is nighttime. I guarantee you're really gonna love them. Thank you. I go to
just kidding. I go to Susan and Lisa's Rad Warehouse, and I mean they have so many great stuff. They have, let's see, casual stuff, and they have dinner outfits, and they have work outfits, and they have summertime outfits. They have all kinds of outfits. They have even shoes. Check out these high heels. I mean, they are so rad. They have tights, nylons. They even have socks and hair ties and sunglasses. I go there for hats, sunglasses, casual clothes. I love casual clothes. They have hair brushes. They have makeup. They have lipstick. Oh my gosh, this place is wonderful. I always go shopping there for like casual stuff and summertime clothes and swimwear too. And I'll show you my sunglasses if you want to see my real eyes. And my hat is beautiful on the top and everything. And here we go. And Justin is cool. Thank you. Three.
Absolutely rad fab warehouse.
baby clothes. I've even got an example of something they have. This right here. I bought this for my little baby brother on his birthday for present. And I mean, he just loves it. We just put it there and he stopped crying. I mean, they have got everything from t-shirts, skirts, socks, shoes, anything. I mean, you're really gonna love it there. I have to tell you my name because I just simply cannot hold it in. My name is Lisa, and I have to go to Susan and Lisa's fabulous shoe hat. I don't have one right on right now, but, you know, hat, hair tie, socks, nylon, skirt, dress, shirt, anything. I mean, I even got this purse there. I mean, they have jumpsuits with, I mean, almost everything they have has pockets. They have belts. They have pants. I mean, every time I go there, I spend at least, I don't know how much money. You know, and they have low prices, too. And they have jewelry. They have earrings, they have necklaces, they have bracelets, they have, I mean, almost anything. Oh, something fell out of my purse.
You don't, I'll...
Oh yeah, I was supposed to advertise this beautiful bracelet. I mean, it is absolutely fabulous. Look at this. It has a buckle, you can squeeze it off your hand, you can unbuckle it. It's fabulous. I mean, there are so many things you can get over here. There's like, okay, just... I did that on purpose, folks. Ah! Of course, you know I did that on purpose. Handy-dandy stools, too. Now, take a look at this. You have a baby at home. You put him in this. It even makes music right down here. I didn't know how to work it. Oh, here it is. Even has music. Can rock your baby to sleep. Look at this. You know, put music where'd it go. Here you go. I mean, this is absolutely fabulous. I mean, you know why they call it fab? They sell shoes. Look at these shoes. Check out these shoes. You don't have to wear socks. I mean, handy dandy, no laces. They sell them with laces because, I mean, some people like laces. And, unfortunately, I don't like them. But I love this purse, and I love that warehouse. I just can't stand it. I mean, there's so many good...
our pizza by the slice, the order will be about $50.
As we pan across to, I'm not getting any focus on you.
Well, adjust it with it. You're recording right now.
See this? Right,
as you can, now it's recording.
All right.
Okay. As you can see, we have seemed to have displaced our car topper top.
As we move in for a very close up.
It is now 9:15. And we're going to pick up our food here at Paladino's Pizza. And we're going to head back on our mission to serve the needy back at Fripp Island. And on the way, we will try to fulfill the need of replenishing our top here, which we seem to have lost down somewhere right around the guard gate at Fripp Island.
We need more evidence as to why this particular top left this vehicle.
I seem to have forgot to place the nut and bolt combination on the top to secure them, and the top seemed to have flown off. But Ken and Barbie are safe, and so is the luggage and the horseshoes and everything else.
When did you first become aware that this top had departed your vehicle?
Well, somewhere back about 4 miles ago, we stopped to urinate over at the fire station at Ladies Island, and when we got out of the car, we noticed that Barbie and Ken and Ken and Barbie's van.
Oh, they're safe. What a heroic thing you did.
And Ken and Barbie's Corvette were exposed to the natural elements, along with strawberry shortcake.
Oh, there she yes.
Sleeping bag and other sleeping bags.
So as you pulled up to the red light and you were concerned,
I was worried about Barbie and Ken.
Yeah, well, I think you were more concerned about the $15 you got to buy for the next top.
Well, the $35 top was a definite concern, and
when you got the information from the people at the red light,
it was not so much the money, okay? It was just the fact of having to return back to the Sun Suites
and the
totally embarrassed without the top, okay? That was my main concern. How do you explain to your family and your guests that you went out to get $20 worth of food and you lost the $30 top?
Well, I think we ought to come back to this, because this is a very interesting tale, and when we find the top,
we will return. Video.
But we did stop at a red light.
That'll be a video first. Really.
And Daryl did say that he thought the top left us about 8 miles from Fripp. And the people at the red light said the top left us
at the guard gate.
At the guard gate.
Here we are at Paladino's Pizza. What do you have to say, John?
We're just bringing some food back for some of the players for the rugby team out of Rutgers. What we like to do is just say the hospitality of the locale.
Uh-huh.
It's excellent.
Is everything taken care of?
Oh, absolutely.
Now you are. Here we are at the guard gate.
Here we are at the guard gate.
Here we are at the guard gate, Fripp Island. We have found our top, okay? We are currently
trying to get back into the vehicle.
Bolting down our top.
Okay. But now we have been to get pizza,
antipastas. 5 minutes before 10 o'clock.
There's Pretty.
Oh, what's that face? Pretty's taking a bath in the kitchen sink.
Hey, Pretty.
Hi.
Oh,
Oh, boy. I think it might be. Again here, poor little Freddy got a little hot under the collar there the first time. There he goes.
There.
Oh, yeah.
How's that?
Oh, yeah, that's much better, huh, Fred?
Look,
yes, it is. Oh, yeah, he likes that.
Mommy gets it in your face. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Don't put that water in your face. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Get that water all over you.
Oh, his privates are all shrunk up. The girls notice that. The girls notice that.
Here we are at Fripp Island, South Carolina.
South Carolina.
Fripp Island. Say, I'm at Fripp.
Fripp Island. Fripp Island.
What did you do today? And then what?
And then we got back to the house.
Did somebody catch a fish?
Yeah.
Who?
Who caught a fish?
Me.
Oh, you did? Was it a big one?
Yeah, it was a big one.
And then what?
Then we go to a little fishing.
And did you see any deer?
I did.
Yes.
How about dolphins?
No! Freddy's first dip in the Fripp waters. Camper. There you go. There he goes. Yeah. What, Danielle? Careful. What have they got, honey?
It is now Christmas Eve. There's the time, ladies and gentlemen. Okay.
Becky is chowing down.
It is now 8:02. And Mom decided to call her brother, Jeff, in Cedar Rapids. She was late to sit down at the table.
And now she's eating the whole 8-pound ham. Beautiful, ain't it? My best friend Angie's mother, Barbara, sent it to us.
Here is the ham.
Angie and Amy. And it's just a beautiful 8-pound ham. And as you can see, Susan over here, she's listening to some classical Christmas songs. Dancing while she can. And beautiful songs from Y100. That's 100.7.
see a honey baked ham. She's sick in the head tonight. She's so happy about her presents. Oh, come over here and see the gingerbread. Susan made this one and this one. We made this one together. And then I made this one. It's an everything tree. And we're just about finished with the gingerbread house itself. And see, it has a little window. And over here is the door. I don't know if you can see it, but there's lifesavers for little circle windows. Let me turn it. And that's the front. Oh, lifesavers. Then the licorice door. Actually, it's like Twizzler. And then the doorknob is a red hot. And on the side, there's two Twizzlers and some red hots. And same thing in the back, except for those three trees. And as you can see, here's the one with the mouse. We use these little silver balls, sort of, and then a peppermint and some frosting we made by ourselves. And we use some chocolate chips and some red hots. And some of the Twizzlers, and we use the little the stuff that you put on cake for flavoring. I don't know what it's called, anyway. Well, and then that's our gingerbread house. And tonight for dinner, we're having buns, cheese with some broccoli, and an 8-pound honey baked ham. And here is Miss Rebecca Bolduc, very happy eating her 8-pound honey baked ham. Do you have anything to say? Good.
It's now 8:05, and
Becky's still chowing down.
Still eating.
Mom to me, but Becky to all of you. Over here, Susan.
Thank you.
Who's that to and who's it from?
It's to Mommy from Susan, Lisa, and Daddy.
To Mommy and Freddie.
Yeah, Mommy and Freddie.
And it's a bike seat.
All right.
Child.
Yeah. What do I put it on?
The buggy we're going to get to.
Ta-da!
And this is and that's from you, the cameraman, which is noticed to Daddy. And this is from Susan and me, Lisa. Okay,
and
we're going
to
put this open present over here. Well, I guess we'll put all the open presents over here, you know, since I'm the manager over here, you know.
Oh, this is the present. Here you go.
Now, I'm going to open my present.
And I'm going to open my
it's
present.
It's to Lisa from the main papé.
This is to Susan from Uncle Greg.
Susan, wait, it's Hill. We have to take turns. And,
this is
from the
day.
Main papé. Pete.
Hold the ring up again so we can get a close-up. Okay.
I can't seem to get it out.
Oh, here's the manager. Very nice. Very nice.
Coming out of a chimney. And this says bracelet. That's the Bolduc children. I like that. That's a pretty neat bracelet. Would you like a close up? Sort of gold and silver with pearls.
Oh, and the scarf also? And bracelet.
Lisa.
Very wonderful looking necklace.
And a ring.
And a ring. And that's from who?
The Bouchards.
I really like it.
I like all my gifts so far.
Me too.
I like all my gifts. Whether I like it or not.
Now,
This is from
Uncle Jeff, and it's to both of us.
You're too close to the light, Sue.
See, like, these are lip glosses, and this is the earring set, and don't ask me what that is.
I've never had anything from Girl Talk before.
This is for the full lip gloss.
Move the wrapping paper out of the way.
Give Bunky her gift. Open Bunky her gift. First, let her sniff it and then open it.
That's Bunky. This is to all the Bolduc children right here.
Okay, now open it up.
Oh. And you know what?
Lisa, huh? Move out.
Green one for Christmas.
There goes Bucky.
Hello, everybody in television land.
There's her tree. Good girl, Bunky. Good girl, Bunky.
Who's that from?
Mamay.
Oh, yeah?
As a matter of fact, we got one of these things from Freddy the other day. And, these are little puppets. We just got him a little doll.
Time for bed.
No!
Now we're gonna see what this thing is all about. Now, I have to do something for Daddy.
I want you to go open your...
Seems that... Where's Susan? It seems that there are a couple more presents that remain unopened. For Susan. One for Susan. And one for Lisa. I have no idea what they are, and I have no way of knowing where they could be coming from.
Where are they?
But here they are. Say ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho. I don't need any help. Go sit down. Ho, ho, ho.
Which one's to me? Which one's mine?
Okay, this one's for Susan and this one's for Lisa.
Thank you.
What's that now?
Holy, that's bigger than mine.
So gross.
That's nice. Oh, yeah.
Hold it up, Sue. Okay, now open that little door. That's where the TV is.
Oh, get real, Dad.
Those two are from Mom and Dad. Okay, let's see how it sounds.
Here's your power.
Does it just take batteries?
Yeah, it does, but we didn't. That's
a nice one, huh, Mom?
Boy, I didn't think it was that big.
Dad loves Sue.
Christmas tree has